Hey guys, it's Kevin. Today I'm going to review this Procolored Panda printer. It's still using the Epson tubes and the dampers, which is surprising because you get the white inks. And also, offset tanks is still the original Epson tanks. It doesn't have separate white tanks. Look like they knock off all the walls inside the white tank, make each tank to be one tank. And you got two tubes goes into the printer. I just cannot get over that they don't have a real direct to damper circulation on the white ink. They use this kind of damper for the white ink. It is an A4 printer. That means they print on A4 paper, a little bit narrower but longer than the regular letter size film. And this temperature control panel is to heat up the printer platform. I'm going to talk about later. And on the top of the cover, you have this humidity meter or temperature meter. That's just like a $10 meter and glue on it. So to understand it a little bit more, we have Abby to remove the casing and see what's inside.
Hey guys, it's Abby here. We're going to be uncasing this L805 DTF printer. It has a panda on it. So let's go ahead and start uncasing it. First, gonna want to turn it off, so our power supply is connected in the back. Let's go ahead and turn the printer around, and this way I can unplug the power supply. This power supply is hidden, but we see where the cable goes to the back, and I'm just making sure that I have the wire out from the bottom of the printer so I can pull it out easy. And the next thing I'm also gonna want to do is take out this USB plug. Turn the printer facing back to us. There really isn't too many screws to actually take out. There's one screw here on the left side on the top that we see. And we'll take that one out and set it to the side. And the other screw is down inside the printer more, but this one's on the right side. Stick your drill in there and unscrew that screw. Take that one out and set it to the side. I'm setting them in a little box. Okay, and then above this temperature monitor, that's where I pull out this little piece. There really was no screws or anything. It's almost just lift up and you can pull it out straight. Towards the back, there's going to be two more screws. You see this slotting area? There's two screws. They're black screws on either side. Take both of those out and put them with your other screws. Again, I set mine in a little box with a magnet in it so they don't get lost. Now we're turning back to the front again. I'm lifting up, but I still feel a little bit of tension somewhere that's holding on to my casing. So I'm just going to slowly not pull too hard because I don't want to break any wiring or anything, but I'm still just trying to find what's connecting me that's not allowing me just to freely take it off. We're going to flip it around to the back again, and that's where I'm feeling that tension still. I see that it's more so having to do with the case, this panda case on top, the white cover, and I see that there's this wire that's connecting to this power button, and that's where I'm going to lay it back carefully. I set this casing back on top of it so I don't pull the wire too hard and disconnect or break anything. Then I lean back the white casing and I see these two screws. So they're smaller screws, they're holding these two wires in. So I use my smaller drill and I unscrew these two small screws. Still be careful and hold on to them. I couldn't get this one to let go, so I just kept it onto my metal bit there for a second until I unscrewed both screws. And then from there, I'll take them both off and put them into my little box with all my other screws. Once both of those screws are off, you can just pull out both of those wires, and they're really easy to take out. So at this point, I was not able just to take out both of those wires at the same time. So it's a little bit of a finagle, but not difficult at all. You just have to lower one wire at a time, lift up the casing, and you'll see both those don't fit at the same time. Raise one up and push one down, and you'll see that it pops through, and our casing is now free, and we can lift the whole casing off. And we are just left with the base and everything running with the printer.
Thanks, Abby, to take it apart. Basically, the printer is using the original Epson tanks. It is a circulating for each tank, so it got two white tanks. And here you can see they have two diaphragm pumps to pump each tank. I don't like this design at all because you have two tanks to manage. You might notice basically the circulation is within the tank, and the ink in the tubes, which you most likely you're gonna clog, is not circulated at all. It just uses original Epson dampers. The difference between negative and positive is the positive dampers, when you put the ink up, this damper is going to have a barometric balance here. So whenever you use the ink, the ink is going to be replenished. However, if you do not use the ink, and the white ink is going to be just sitting here, because you're only circulating the inside the tank, you are not circulating. What I'm suggesting is this thing works for regular inks, but for white inks, you need a direct damper circulating. And the tube size, I think, is on the border. You just need to replace the damper to negative pressure damper. It seems that this printer is designed to do as minimum as possible. But it did tell you it's a Panda printer, so you know what you're going to get, right? I'm making a modification kit that you can modify this kind of printer into direct damper circulation. I'm going to put a detailed step-by-step video in this channel. Let's check this heater. There's a power comes in, heats up this platform. If you put your hands here, you're going to feel warm. And you'll see lots of those heaters in a lot of $2,000 printers. So this is, personally, I don't find it really helpful. If you get the red ink, it doesn't matter if you heat up here or not. But this one does has it. So the power supply is from this little power converter box, 24 volt. The direct to damper system I designed, that you can just put two wires into this power supply and basically just put a tag on it and draw the power from there. Here you can see this two, the AC input, and then one of the output goes to the pump and the heater. Another one goes to this programming board on the left. And this is the main board. Some of the FS cable get rewired into this board. You can see this board is called LL5 signal controller board. Basically, you have all the signals from the printer, for example, paper feed or paper ejection. And this controller overrides those signals, so it lets you be able to use the film. I have another video and also have detailed documents about how you wire the main board and the signal control board. If you go to bchtechnology.com and you search for LAO5, here's a workflow sheet for Epson LAO5. This one has a PDF file of the board picture and also has a video about the connections of the board and the signal board. Also, if you're a member of this channel, and the video is also in the member section. So overall, I'm not totally impressed, or you might say underwhelmed, about this printer. However, the cover is cute, so when you put it in your house, your friends might come over and say, "Hey, what's that?" Okay, I hope this review is helpful for you. Please visit us at www.bchtechnologies.com or locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers.